Amen. All right, everybody. Thank you again, as I always say, because I really do appreciate you. Everybody, and every time you see my face or you see that I'm coming on, I really want you to know that I do appreciate you very, very much for stopping by. Some of you may just stop by for a few seconds. Some stop by for a little bit longer. And I pray that whenever I'm on, that you are receiving something from God that is motivational. I pray that you're receiving something from God that is inspiring you and motivating you to continue. So let me give a few others an opportunity to connect with us before I get started in what I feel led of God to share. So please do me a favor. You all know what I'm going to ask, right? Share, invite somebody. I have a strong message tonight. I have a strong message on tonight. So please share this with somebody. Please share this with somebody. Hi, Joy. I haven't seen you in a while. How are you, Sister Joy? Hello, Renee. How you doing? I pray you're doing good. Chanel, hey, over there on the West Coast. How you doing? How you doing? Now, you know I remember you because I can't pronounce your name. I'm going to say Miss Sophus. I hope I said that right. I pray. I'm still battling a little bit of a cough right now, but I'm good. I'm good, you all. Share this. Would you all do that? Now, listen. Miss Sophus, have you subscribed to my YouTube channel? Prophetically Speaking, I see you right down there. Would you be so kind? You all, I told you, I wanted 5. I wanted 100, rather, subscribers by the 5th. I wanted 100. Now, I believe the last time I just checked, I'm 5 people away. Just 5. So I need 5 of y'all. Go on right now. Do it right now. And subscribe. Did you subscribe for that? Thank you so very much. How you doing, Melinda? How you doing? You know what? I think I'm a little slow now, Melinda, because I don't know everybody. But I believe your dad, isn't your dad the radio announcer? Or used to be a radio announcer there. Is that your father? He works in the sound booth there. Is that your daddy? Is that your daddy? Everybody, you know, I want to go, really, you don't have to go there in scripture. Many of you may already know it, but I want to go to Acts, the 19th chapter is where I want to go. But just something I want to deal with there. No, Acts, the 12th chapter. That's what it is, Acts, the 12th chapter. But the Lord spoke something to me today. The Lord spoke something to me today. Many people, you hear them say, I'm waiting on God. I'm waiting on God. And I'm going to do a, yeah, that is your daddy, huh? That's your daddy. I'm going to do a teaching again about hearing the voice of God. I feel led to do that. How you doing, Renee? How you doing, my dear? Oh, that's that singer there. She be singing. I saw you selling some clothes the other day, I think. I believe I saw you. Congratulations to what you're doing. And you know what, saints of God, I want to say this. Sometimes we move too slow. Sometimes we move too slow. Somebody just subscribe. Who is Little Miss Nerd? Thank you very much for doing that. Sometimes we move too slow. You know, one time I was in the, I was getting ready to do a television taping. And I was in the makeup chair and they were putting makeup on me, whatever. And I was looking in the mirror and the Lord spoke a word to me. And he told me this, the devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. I'll never forget that. Now, the devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. I remember he told me that. And I'm like, well, what does that mean? And I immediately got the revelation. I was thinking about doing something at that time in the early 80s or maybe, well, no, when was it? 90s, in the 90s. That was the outbreak of the psychic hotline. And I felt in my spirit, I said, well, if the psychics can do it, I believe I can do it. And my mind told me, the people go talk about you. How you doing, Shereen? They go talk about you. They go laugh at you. They go really say you're not of God. Now, really, even at that time, can we talk for a few minutes, y'all? Even at that time, Renee, my gifting was a little different than some other prophets. You know, most prophets would come, yea, the Lord, see your storm, and the Lord is working out some things for you, because I see God and some people are jealous of you. Am I talking to you? And you're going through some financial matters, but the Lord is telling me to tell you, trouble don't last always. I see you crossing over some water. God is getting ready to call you to cross over that muddy Jordan, and you're going to walk into your land of victory. Am I talking to you? Now, if you hear that, anybody ever heard prophecy like that, give me a heart. Anybody ever heard prophecy like that? Give me a heart. Because if you hear that, that could apply to anybody. You know, that could apply to anybody. It's like, you know, yeah, the Lord's here. I'm going, yeah, people jealous of me. Who is on here that don't have nobody jealous of you? So, you know, I'm not saying that they are not real prophets. I'm not saying that. That's their level of prophecy. I just believe that there's more that God can say if we let him. There's more that God can say. So I really wanted to know, what was the storm they were going through? What were they going through in the water? I wanted to be more specific. And I want to tell you one reason why is because I saw psychics on television being more specific. So I'm like, well, if they can be more specific, I can too. So I thought that whatever the psychics were doing, I can do it as a child of God. Exactly, my sister. It is too general. Y'all know that's my real sister, my real blood sister. She helped raise me. It was just too general. And so it can apply to anybody. Some people, they cry, yes, Lord, because it is true. It got some people jealous of you. But now, so I launched a psychic line or 1-900 number. That's what they called it back then. I started that. I think I still have a flyer with that on there. And oh my God, I will not forget that, because I had people that, I mean, blackballed me. They talked about me, got on the radio and said, you ain't got to pay no prophet. You ain't got to pay me. I prophesy to you free. You know, they were throwing what we call now throwing shade at me. And it hurt my feelings. I'm like, God, I thought I was advancing the kingdom. You know, because, you know, it's $3.99 and some, you know, a dollar per minute or whatever it was. But, and I had people that would call, and then they wouldn't pay their bill. You know, they would, because the phone company, they won't force you to pay the bill. That was back in the day. That was in the 90s. And so I just said, God, if I missed you, I'm sorry. Because I had people coming to me and said, that ain't of God. Brother Mosley, Bishop Mosley, that's not of God. And one lady, she was a woman of God, a preacher, even stopped me one day. I was at some... I don't know where I was. I was working. I was coming out of somewhere, some building. And she was working as a security guard. Now, this is something. I think I was coming out of a bank and she saw me. And she was, this is a pastor now, working as a security guard. And she kind of told me, well, Dr. Moses, I was one of them ones that, oh, no, Bishop Moses, I was one of them ones that I just didn't think that was of God. And I'm like, but now, and the Lord told me, not making fun of her, but the Lord told me, now, Mosley, look at what she's doing. She's working as a security guard, and she's a pastor. But now, I told you to do this, and you were still getting your money. But she is going to get her money by being a security guard. Nothing wrong with that, but I felt like that was beneath her abilities. Am I making sense? Can I get a few more hearts? Am I making sense? I'm not trying to poke fun at anybody. But what I'm telling you, what the Lord told me was, Michael, the devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. Because I, like so many other people, were worried, what are the people going to say? What are the preachers going to say? They may not invite me to preach. Because, can I be real for a moment? When the preacher goes off to preach, that's how we also earn our finances. That, you know, that's how the portions of the offering does go to the evangelist. And that's how we eat and how we live. I pray I'm making sense now. Belinda, are you still on here? Pray with me, y'all, right? And so, people did. They stopped calling me. They said, oh, he just trying to be one of them psychics. Well, what I was really trying to prove was whatever the psychics can do, we as a prophet or prophets of God can do and do it better. That's what I was trying to prove. You know, anybody can be a good singer in your own church, but when you step out and you go to somebody else's church, can you really still sing? Okay, now you mastered that level. Now, I want you to step out. Let's go to the club and see if you can sing real good. If you can master the club, now you really are good. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. You are a wonder amongst this group, but step out. Step out and do greater. Come on, if you can really, I've called myself a prophet because I didn't want my prophetic ability just to work in church. I don't know, I'm in the church, okay. But I wanted to see, will this gift work outside of the church? Will it work while I'm in the airplane? Will it work while I'm in the washing terrier? Will it work while I'm walking through the park? Will it work in a business meeting? If I really have a gift, it shouldn't just wait until I'm in the church to wake up. Am I making sense? It shouldn't wait until I'm in the church. Or you can only sing this. No, that's some gospel singer. Aretha could really sing. You put anything in front of Aretha. That's why so many people had great respect when she sang that opera. Aretha can sing gospel, but she knew, and her daddy knew, honey, this gift is beyond the church. You got to, because you're, and I'm going to help somebody. Don't be mad at me. But the church is only going to make you so much money. We all proud of Aretha, at least I am, because she stepped out of the church, not away from God. Ooh, that did something for me right there. Chanel, that did something for me. I felt the power of God right there. She did not leave God. She just stepped out the church. When she stepped out of the ark of safety, that ain't the ark of safety. The ark of safety is in the will of God. Can I get an amen right there? How you doing, Ariana? The will of God, that's the ark of safety. If you're in his will, woo, hallelujah. And when she died, they tell me she had checks that she still hadn't cashed. Oh, thousands of dollars that she still had not cashed. God, and we're talking about, you got to be in the will of God. I am in the will of God. Somebody right now, I pray I'm prophesying to somebody right now. I really do. I pray somebody realize you are in his will. You just may not be in the church will. You may not be in the church wheel. And then we have the nerve of Aretha, God rest her soul, you know what I'm saying. If she was to walk in one of our church, ooh, we go get a good offer. Praise God, she's here. No. Because you said, I'm not in the wheel of God. The devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. That's what he told me. And because I'm so busy worried about what other people go say, what they go do. And I mean, I had people just talking about me. I had people laughing at me. I did. So now, what are you saying, Dr. Mosley? The Lord spoke this word to me just a few moments ago. You know, stop waiting on God and move with God. Because see, we tell you, I'm waiting on God. God is this you. I'm waiting on God. Many times that is an excuse. That is a moment of procrastination. God is still saying, like he told me, the devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. We done got so fearful to move in God. Now, y'all help me. Is there a scripture that says, if you made your bed in hell, is he not there? In other words, you can't lose. You can't lose. If you would just trust, I remember I told the Lord, I heard my pastor say this. Well, God, I thought you told me, but if you didn't tell me, I really thought you told me. And you know what? I believe God will bless you because you thought he told you. You had enough faith. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you something right now. I told this the other night. There were times that I did kind of live, not kind of, I did. I lived above my means. But I felt God still blessed me because I went for it. I went for it. I tried God. You know, we tell people, try Jesus. He's all right. Why don't you try Jesus? He's all right. Well, why don't you try him? Why don't we try? No. I feel the anointing getting stronger. Y'all, help me. Help me. God is saying, you saying I can do all things? Well, why don't you try? Step out. I'm trying to make sure God is just really you. Well, if it's not him, he'll catch you before you fall. Am I right about it? Well, my heart's. Well, my heart's right here. God will catch you before you fall. He'll present you faultless. Leave him alone, because they were doing it for my glory. They were doing it for me to be happy. They were, they don't know my shaya. Well, mama, I was making a cake for you, but it burnt. Baby, that's all right. Just the fact that you did it for me. You were thinking about me. Oh, bless his name. God is trying to tell somebody, you waiting on me? I'm the one that watched this, gave you the idea. Ooh. I'm the one that put it in your spirit, and you go call yourself waiting on me? Hello? Am I making sense? I'm the one that put it, I dropped it in your spirit. And y'all, I can't, I'm going to talk about this this weekend. I can't tell you how many times God have given me ideas and I was too slow to act upon them. Too slow. And then you know what? I had the nerve to get mad at somebody else that did. I had the nerve, Renee, to get mad that somebody else did it. I'm sitting in the Lord and saying, well, I did tell you first, but you didn't want to do it. So I had to go somewhere else. Because you know what? Can I tell y'all this? Now, some of my, those of you that are mature in God, you go catch this. God is about progress. He's about business. Can I go here? He's about making that money. Not always, but not the only thing. But he's about making somebody right now. You say, Lord, I need some money. Lord, I need some money. He'll give you an idea. And here you go. I'm waiting on the Lord. Lord, confirm it. Lord, is this really you? Blink the lights on and off. Lord, let the prophet prophesy something to me if this is really you. Lord, and God said, oh, okay, you move too slow, baby. You too slow. When God told me to start doing what I'm doing now on the internet, on Facebook, now, because I'm going to tell you the truth, I didn't see a whole lot of preachers do this. I did not see. Now, guess what? All day long, y'all, am I telling the truth? All day long, there are prophets and preachers. I'm not mad. I'm thanking the Lord. But when I started, there weren't too many people doing it. There weren't too many preachers prophesying. And now you see a whole lot of people. Because I had somebody, y'all, am I teaching good? I had somebody, look at Dr. Mosley, put his Cash App on there, taking up an offering on the internet. Now I go to their page, and they got a Cash App. People will talk about you, but when they see it starting to work, and people are having testimonies and they are being blessed. And ooh, I better get with the program too. I better start doing it. No, you know, am I making sense, y'all? The devil is ahead and we are too slow. We are just too slow. Because I've been saying this, and you know what, now with the coronavirus and everything going, there are more and more people that are afraid to even go to church, to get out of the house and to walk even to the Walmart or wherever. And we've been fighting against Facebook ministry. The Bible said, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. My mother called me one time before she passed away. And she said, you ain't forsaking the assembly. They coming together, just coming together by the means of Facebook. We coming together. We getting the same thing as we would if we was in church, in the building. You're still preaching. You're still teaching. You're still healing. You're still praying. You're still singing. It's the same thing. The only thing is, you're not using gas money to go. You're not using your clothes to go. Maybe you're in your pajamas watching me right now, but you can still feel the presence of God. If you open your mind, you can reopen your heart. You can still, can I get 10 hearts? Anybody can feel his presence? Anybody can feel his presence? All God is trying to tell some of us, maybe if you would have moved fast enough, Maybe God would have given you the idea of the how to heal the coronavirus. How you doing, Jennifer? God bless your heart. Saints of God, God is saying, we are moving too slow. And the devil, oh, the devil is just ahead. And we say, I'm waiting on God. I'm waiting on God. I can tell you, I really cannot tell you how many people I prophesied to over this platform, and God have honored the word. It has manifested for them. They have given their offering, and God prospered them. It's the same thing. No, you can't have that, honey. We got to come to the house of prayer. Well, in your house, a house of prayer? Is it your house now? And I'm coming in. If you let me in through your phone, through your computer, we're praying together. How we touch it and agreeing. You don't need to physically touch. What we need to do is mentally touch. Ooh, am I making sense? Saints of God, there's somebody on here right now. God is telling you and myself, I've given you the idea. Why you haven't moved on it? Why haven't you? You're afraid of what people go say, what they may do, what they, but are you hearing what I'm saying? And yet, you know, thank you, Jesus. I hear the Lord saying, say it. Okay, Lord. But you know what? Sometimes sometimes I wish I wasn't part of the church in a sense, because church people can be some of the most negative, slow people. But we say, oh, look at the world. The world is worse today than it was 20 years ago. No, they are more advanced. The same sin that went on 30 years ago is the same sin that's going on today. I don't care what you say. People sleeping, the priest sleeping with the little boys, and the preacher sleeping. Still, it was going on 30 years ago. ain't nothing new. Huh? Help me. Am I making sense, Sister Jennifer? Am I making sense? Ain't nothing new. The same stuff going on. Same sex scenes or whatever you want to call it. But they advancing. We want to sit here and pray all day and trying to get a confirmation. And God said, oh, Lord, go for it, baby. Go ahead on. And we said, Lord, give me another sign. Lord, is this really you? Go on, baby. We're afraid to get married. Well, what if he go crazy? What if he? And I understand that. But if you feel the Lord telling you, go for it. I was married before. Yes, I was. Somebody said, well, you married the wrong one. No, I did not. I married the right one for that time. Oh, now somebody ain't gonna like me now. And when it was over, and God yet held my hand. God yet held her hand. God held the hands of our children. Am I making sense? Come on. But then Lord, I'm just too scared. People crazy out there. They crazy everywhere. They crazy even in church. They crazy everywhere. But the Lord is saying, you're the one that's really crazy because you don't want to trust me. You don't want to believe me. Stop waiting on God and start moving with God. You know, have you ever been in a storm and that all of a sudden it's like the wind just boom? And God is saying, you need to go with me. Come on, let's go. Let's do this. Sometimes you speak like a whirlwind. You'll come like thunder. And you still, Lord, give me a sign. Some of you, God have told you to start your business. So, thank you, Jesus. I just heard the Lord. Somebody's watching me. I want you to plant a 133. For some reason, that's what he just said, a 133. I want you to plant a 133 seed offering right now. I want you to plant that 133 seed. Whoever you are, I want you to do it really quickly. The Lord is telling somebody right now, please hear me. I'm trying to advance you. I'm trying to get you out. I was just speaking to a lovely young lady, and I gave her a word about a year or two ago, and now she's starting to see. And I told her, I told her, so now when I gave you that word, you was very kind, but you politely bucked me. You didn't want to receive that one. But now she understands. I should have listened to you back then. God is trying to tell so many of us, If you would have moved like when I told you to move, instead of worried about what Miss Sabrina go say or what Miss Daphne go say or what Reverend Michael going to say, if you would just move when I tell you. Peter was in jail, and the angel came to Peter and said, "Rise up, Peter. Lord, is this really you? Lord, is it? Give me another sign. I want to see another angel." You ain't got time for all of that. Can I get somebody to tell the Lord thank you? You don't have time for all. Look, get up. Rise up, Peter. Well, what if the chains make noise? What if they go kill me? What? I can't do this. Look, I can't do this. And that's the way some of the saints are. Well, my pastor ain't going to allow this. And I understand. But okay, well, I don't have enough money for this. Well, I can't go. I ain't going down to ask for no job. They may tear me down. They may laugh at me. And I only got a fourth grade education. Come on now. Come on. Come on now. Well, go ask them, do they need somebody to work this shift? You could. They ain't going to talk about me. They ain't going to laugh at me. What if I try and it don't work? What if I get up and I don't? What if I get up and the man with the knife come and slit my throat? What am I going to do? And I believe God is saying, "Oh Lord, I wonder who can the Lord pray to? He's like, Lord, help my children. Oh, that's me." He has given so many of us what we call an idea. Can somebody write that one word, idea? He's given somebody, really all of us, an idea. And can I be honest about myself? Woo, y'all, I got to get ready to pray. Somebody, I want you to plant your offering really quickly. I want you to plant that somebody to give that 133. That those of you, I want you to give, I don't know why he's saying this, there are 12 people to give a $33 seed. Whoever you are, this is what he's showing me. I want you to plant your seed. You may not have the 33, you give the 22 or the 11. You give the 88, whatever you can. God, I feel a move. That's why I have to tell you this right now. I really do feel a move. But God, thank you, sister. And God is telling somebody, idea. Your success starts with an idea. Everything starts with an idea. Whatever you're watching me on, if it's a computer, if it's a phone, it started as an idea. The cup started as an idea. The light started as an idea. Your $1 million is starting with an idea. Woo! Y'all, I done got myself so happy, I'm trying to calm down. It has started with an idea. And God is saying, look at here, if you're not going to use it, if you're not going to do nothing with it, move out the way. Let me get somebody else that's ready to jump on this thing. Let me get, it's like somebody told me, like the stock market, you got to move when it's time to move, and then you got to pull out when it's time to pull out. When the angel, when Jesus came to the brother at the pool of Bethesda, he said, "Do you want to be whole? I don't have nobody. Look here, I ain't got time for all of that. Rise, take up your bed and walk." Move! Oh my God, everything starts. Lord, I want more of your spirit. Well, I'm trying to give it to you as an idea. Lord, give me more of your anointing. I'm trying to give it to you as an idea. Lord, I want a new house. I'm trying to give you the money for it as an idea. Lord, I done got happy here. I done got happy. God is telling somebody right now, it starts with an idea. Cherie, it starts with an idea. You can do this thing. You know, Cherie, don't be mad at me, but I hear him very clear. The reason why your money is scarce is because you have been avoiding, you're not paying attention to the idea. I don't know if anybody else received that. I'm not trying to be mean, but that's what I hear. He said, Michael, the reason why you may have some problems, because you're not paying attention to the idea. If you would really pay attention, I told you. And then sometimes, y'all, I wonder, well, God, if I do this, what am I going to do next year? What am I going to do next week? What am I, don't you remember every day my mercies are new? Don't you know I got another idea? How many of us started with an iPhone started with maybe the iPhone, I don't know, the 4 or the 5. And then they came up with another one, 6, and I had the 6. Then they came with the 8. And yeah, am I making it? The XR and the iPhone 10 and iPhone 11. God! I'm too excited, y'all. God never runs out of ideas. He never runs out of ideas. Never. So somebody right now, well, if I cook chicken today, what am I going to cook tomorrow? Didn't the scripture say, take no thought what you shall eat or drink for tomorrow? For tomorrow will take care of the things of itself. In other words, I got an idea for you for tomorrow. I remember sometimes God would tell me, go shopping today. And I'm like, I don't feel like, I'll wait. I'll wait to do it tomorrow. Tomorrow come. And my schedule gets so busy until I didn't get a chance to go do it. And then all the time, I told you to go yesterday, but you didn't want to pay attention to the idea. Then I realized I missed that sale. I told you to go shopping. I had somebody right there to tell you about it. But no, you didn't want to do it. Okay. Your loss. Joy, are you still on here? I thank you for your seed offering, my dear. Joy, now when I said your name, I just said it 2 times. And I hear the Lord saying, it comes in the morning. It comes in the daylight. There's an idea. There's an awakening that is taking place. Now, I don't know, Joy, I thank you, but I hear the Lord clearly saying in my ear, get your business started. You shall make your own money. Well, next thing he's telling me, you shall live in a land of luxury. And really, the Lord has given you things freely to enjoy. The only reason why you're not doing it is you're not paying attention to the idea. The devil is ahead. Yeah, the devil got my car. The devil got my money. The devil took my marriage. Well, if you would have paid attention to the idea, he wouldn't have taken your husband. He wouldn't have taken your wife. And if he would have, you would have been up on the game. You would have been prepared for it. You would have had your little savings account. Now, somebody not going to like my preaching now, but I need 20 hearts right here. Can I get 20 more? You would have been prepared for it. You really would have been prepared for it. But saints of God, pay attention to the idea. Somebody, the Lord is telling you, there's an idea. Why don't you fry some chicken or make his favorite meal tonight? I ain't doing that. He ain't even changed the light bulb. But see, God is trying to tell you to hold on to him because there's Felicia back there at the office. She going to make him some brownies tomorrow. And I'm trying to get you ahead of Felicia. But now you go let your pride block you from receiving my idea. You go allow your insecurity to block you from receiving the idea. Woo! Is God talking to anybody on here tonight? And I'm going to be honest, he's talking to me. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Speak, Lord. Because I got to pay attention to the idea. You got to pay attention. There have been things that God have told me to teach about that I'm like, oh, and I'm already on the hit list because I've talked about this and I've talked about that. And the Lord has said, I thought you were working for me. Are you working for me? Are you working for people? Ladies and gentlemen, the devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. Stop waiting on God. And move with God. Right now, and I have to tell you, thank you. Those of you that are planting your offering right now, I want you to know this. I want you to plant your seeds. Don't second guess. No, you need to do this. You need to do this. I kid you not. You really need to do this. I don't know why I'm seeing 24 hours. Somebody, the Lord is just trying to test you to see, are you going to move with me? Because your investment tonight, and that's what this is, will return in 24 hours. There's somebody. There are 3 people that God has asked you to plant this 133. There are 12 of you that God has asked you to plant this $33. And maybe you may have the 11. You do it. You do what the Lord has laid upon your heart. But Renee Clemens, are you on here? Are you on here, my dear? I, 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 Y'all, I feel his anointing so. I feel his anointing. I really do. Saints of God, go with the idea. Go with the idea. Get it. God is giving you a way. Isn't that scripture that said that he will give us a way to escape? You see that hole right there? Go through there. But Lord, I don't know. What's on the other side? Oh, God. He said, Peter, rise up. And I thank God Peter got up and the chains fell off. How them soldiers did not hear them chains, I don't know and I don't care. God is telling somebody, I'm prospering you. I'm prospering you. Move. When I tell you to move, move. When I tell you to get up, get up. When I tell you to praise me, praise me. When I tell you to be quiet, be quiet. When I tell you to sow and to give, sow and give. When I tell you, when you feel it, well, stop. I want another confirmation. Lord, is this really you? Lord, is this really? And think about that question. Think about that. Lord, is this really you? Now you're talking to him and then you go ask him, is this really you? So that means you do recognize him, but you wonder, is this really you, or is this the devil? Is this myself? Even if you miss God, will he not prosper you? Oh, thank you, Ms. Sophus. Even if you miss God, will he not? God, I feel your anointing. God is telling somebody, look at here. Again, I'm telling you, your million is starting with an idea. Your blessing is starting with an idea. Somebody, God is trying to tell you, all you need is an idea. And I'm giving you that, but you keep talking yourself out of the idea. If you just follow the idea, well, I believe I'll start this, but I don't know. Somebody, God may tell you, it may sound simple. Well, ain't nobody gonna buy no brownies from me. Ain't nobody gonna, well, how do you know that? How do you know that? Well, if that's what you believe, then okay, fine. But God gave you an idea. God gave you an idea to pick a baked cake and take it to somewhere and sell it. God gave you the idea. Am I talking to anybody? No. Shaya. Am I talking to anybody right now? God, but you're moving too slow. You got the ingredients right there. And then I understand. I'm about to say something. I don't mean to be mean, but sometimes we get kind of lazy. No, get up from there. I got to feed my children. I got to do something. God did not give you those children for you all to sit there and starve. Lord, I want you to help me, and he's helping you right now with an idea. That's an idea, y'all. Am I talking to anybody here? Sharita has an idea. Crystal, thank you for being on, my dear. Your name sounds very familiar. I know you. Crystal has an idea. There's an idea. Hasha Roshkiryanda Yadalabosha. Are you finished with school? Well, let me just tell you what I hear. Crystal, I don't know who right now. I know you. I just can't put it together. But the Lord is telling me to tell you, return to school. Return to school. Return. 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 That's what he's telling me, return. I want, God, oh, Melinda, you have an idea. You know what? And I hear this. If you have an idea, you have the potential to make money. Money is attracted to ideas. That's why we call it investors. I need an investor for this. Well, you got to first get the idea and get it out. Write it down. Speak it out. Talk. And then we say, well, I don't want nobody to take my idea. I understand that too. I thought it was Pastor Ann. Blessings to you. That's great. I know you don't want nobody to steal your idea, but that means you got to move faster. Because if you move too slow, you know what? You go look up and somebody else go have that idea. And you're like, what happened? I thought the Lord told me. He did, but darling, you move too slow. And you know why? Because there are people that need that idea. There are people that need the answer. There are people that need that cosmetic design. There are people that need that new dress that you just thought of. There are people that need, they hungry. That's somebody tomorrow that want a slice of that apple pie, whatever that God has given you to make. As somebody that don't want to, I don't even want to cook, but and God, well, I want to be a chef. Well, I can cook for you, and I'll prepare the meal for you, and I'll do it all for, you know, $50, $70, whatever. Okay. Yeah, I don't feel like doing it. There's somebody that they need you to come clean their house, and I'll pay you. There's somebody that need their grass cut. They need the flower, and you love planting flowers. Am I talking? God is telling somebody has an idea. God bless you, Crystal. Blessings to you, my dear. I don't know why, but I keep hearing school. So whatever you, now notice this, whatever you're doing in school is to help you with your own way of making money. I'm not saying you won't work for somebody else, but I will say you will have almost the way he's giving it to me, like a side hustle or a side business that will help you financially to acquire or to get the car that you've asked God about. That's what he's telling me. If you can, I want you to plant that offering right now, my dear. Somebody else is you're planning that 133. Somebody else, you're planning that 33. No, shut. Somebody else, you're planning that $33. Somebody else, I really do hear this 133. So if somebody else, you are planning, and I thank you, those of you that have done that. I want you to trust God. Somebody else, you have $11. You plant that because I have an idea. Some of us, we move too slow. We just move too slow. The portal is open. The heavens are raining. God, let me get in on this. Do you know what? There's somebody right now, I wish they would have got in on the Apple computer industry. When it was low, they wish they would have got in on it. There's a thing going around now about Bitcoin. There's somebody wish they get in on it. I wish I would have got in on this. Because it starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. I want you to, Lord, help me, okay? I'm getting ready to give you an idea. And you know what? It's something you can do. Those of you that want prayer, put your prayer request right there. Let me pray. Cherie, you want to encourage your children with ideas. You want to encourage your children with ideas. Give me an idea. Y'all got any ideas for dinner tonight? No. Encourage them for ideas. Get their mind to thinking. Get their mind to thinking. What can we do with this? Get their minds to thinking of an or for an idea. When we need money, we need success, we need an idea. We need an idea. Brother TJ Hill, new job. You need a job. What type of work are you doing? Or what type of work are you looking for? Tell me that. What type of work are you looking for? What type of work? Can you answer that for me real quickly? What type of work are you looking for? Now, I don't know who you are, what you do right now. And forgive me because I can't really see a picture. Somebody told me the other day, you act like you don't even know me. Baby, I'm sorry. When I'm up here in the anointing, I really didn't. But now I know who you are. I know who you are. TJ, aren't you from, didn't I just see you? Are you in Baltimore? God, I thank you for TJ Hill. Okay. Now, if I have the person correctly in my spirit, and if you're not, you reminded me of that person. Please understand this. You're gifted in technology and education. You are that person. Okay. You're gifted in technology and education. It looks like I'm holding up. It's like I have an iPad or my Apple phone, but it's helping me to work in education. So now I need you to realize what you're, and again, please, I have to be redundant. It's a new idea. I want you to plan a $33 offer. I'm sorry. I want you to plan a 133. Money's tight, but it's not gone. I want you to plan a 133. I was seeing I was seeing it, but I thought he was highlighting the 33. But he said, no, 133. Now, hear me carefully. Look right at me, TJ Hill. I don't want you, the Lord is saying, do not deny me. Do not deny me. I want to bless you, but the blessing I have for you must equal your imagination. I never heard that before. I really want to write that down. The blessing, see, because the Lord is saying that it's like there's more for you. That's why I'm looking at the phone and the Apple phone and stuff. I'm looking at it because it's a sign of progression. But it's like, God, I don't know. It's like you drawing back. I don't know. Is this really possible? Can it be done? And God is saying, yes, I have given you a new method of reaching younger people, even people with behavioral issues. I've given you a method to reach them. I've given you a compassionate heart to be patient with them. That's what he's telling me. Now, don't deny me. Now, the Lord is telling me, I want your success to teach for you. I don't know if that makes sense, but he's telling me, I want your success. They can look at you and even what you wear to school and what you do, how you carry yourself. I want to be like, he must know what he's talking about then. And that's the impression that I'm getting. I want you to plant that 133. I kid you not. I always said I kid you not, but that's I'm not kidding you. That's what I hear. Crystal, can you pray for my mom's health? Cheryl Williams, God, I ask that you would touch, and they open up her breathing. All of a sudden, my lungs feel like I'm getting closed up. God, open up the breathing in the lungs. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I give you praise for her right now. Gina Haley, prayer for my daughter. What's the issue with the daughter? Tell me, what's the issue with the daughter? What is the issue with the daughter? Somebody said this on Facebook. Jennifer Wilson, I need an idea. No. He said, no, you don't need an idea. You need to act upon your ideas. Don't be mad at me, Jennifer. He said, you need to act upon your ideas with an S. I don't know why I hear cooking, training. And it's like ministering, but I feel like you're praying. But cooking, training, and let's say praying. So I believe that's ministry, okay? Cooking, training, and ministry. Now, you know, ministry is, it could be a lot of things. Ministry can be cooking. That's why he said praying, okay? But how's that going to make me some money? Now, I don't know the cooking and training and praying, but it will. If you follow through. And can I tell you this also, sweetheart? It's like sometimes when you go through one door, God will open up other doors and opportunities for you. Opportunities will come and just like go through one door and then another door will open, another idea and another idea. But I keep hearing cooking, training, and praying. Now, that may not make any sense to you. I'm sorry, but that's what I hear. Cooking, training, and praying. And the praying is like ministry. So I don't know if you have a ministry. I don't know if you're preaching. I don't know what you're doing, but I have to tell you, cooking, training, and ministry are praying, okay? Who else was I need? So Jennifer, I'm praying. Gina, I'm still waiting. What is the problem with your daughter? If you can explain it to me really quickly. God, Cherie, I want you to encourage your children. Encourage them with an idea, with an idea. With an idea, praying for everything to get better financially and my children. It is. Follow the idea. And I don't mean to be redundant, but that's what he's telling me. As soon as I'm talking, I hear the answer quickly. Follow the idea. Follow the idea. You know what? Someone made this statement. If you want something you've never had before, you got to do something you've never done before. So sometimes, and I'm talking to you right now and others, sometimes we got to change our routine, change our regimen, change our thinking. It's time to think bigger. I can do this. I can do this. I can do this. I need you to put this in your mind. I can do this. It just seems like it's so small. Anybody gonna want this? Anybody gonna need this? Yes. Jennifer, are you still on here? Who needs a healing, Jennifer? I'm picking up an issue with a back problem, and I'm picking up a skin issue. It's like something with the skin. It's very, very dry. Very, very dry. Let me know, Jennifer, who is there, someone with a back-related issue, and I'm picking up a very dry skin. It's something, is psoriasis dealing with the skin? Because I hear that word in my ear, psoriasis. Psoriasis, I don't know, I hear that word in my ear. And it may not be what it is, but I have to tell you, and sometimes being a prophet, I see things that are not here. I see things that are not here, but my job is to pray to avoid it. But that's what I'm hearing, okay? Please keep our areas hit by the tornadoes in Tennessee, and for the people that haven't been found and the families that lost members here. Yes. And you know what? Right now, in the midst of Nashville, God is going to send a plethora of ideas. We can do this. We can do this. We can do this. Well, how are we going to recover? Lord, just give us an idea. We'll follow it. We'll follow it. I really do feel, I feel the spirit of ideas. Because you know what, saints of God? Can I tell you this? Gotcha. I got you, Gina. Thank you. When you don't have an idea, it causes you not to be motivated. An idea motivates you to see tomorrow. An idea, it prompts you to get up for what you gonna do tomorrow. Oh, I got an idea. I'm going shopping. Are we going to have a picnic? Are we going to the amusement park? Whatever. Your idea. So right now, Nashville will survive because God is releasing a plethora of ideas. Claudia, I'm praying for your daughter. She's in Nashville as well. Well, God, we lift up Claudia's daughter. But now I want God to restore her heart. That was a devastation with the storm, but her heart has been devastated. It's like her heart has been crushed. All right. Gina, so you really just confirmed what I just said. I see the note that you sent me about ideas. If we don't have an idea, we'll be crushed. Gina, I'm praying that the Lord will release idea. Gina, I want you to plant a $33 seed for your daughter. I want you to plant a $33 seed for your daughter. Now, the reason why we plant money because we want to get money, and I believe that. But with her, I'm praying for money to strengthen her and to carry her to a new place of self-esteem. I know that sounds funny, but this is what I hear. Lord, let money, because you know what? We have it. First, we get an idea and let money come in and support that idea. I think I want to move, or I think I want to go to the store. Well, you need money in for the gas or whatever to get you to the store, to get you to the park. So now God is going to cause a shift to take place with your daughter. You will see the shift by April the 13th. That's what he's telling me. You will see the shift by April the 13th. Watch God. Watch God. Now, you did try to warn and you did try to cover, but that's okay. God is still going to bless. But right now, let's say it this way, the eyes will be open to really see what you were saying. Woo! I feel the power of God. I feel the power of God. Somebody right now, who else is planting your seed? James, I thank you so very much, my friend. James, I just felt a wind. I just felt the wind. I kind of did like this. So there's a wind. The wind is to push you in front of somebody that have greater influence to promote you. So there's a wind to push you in front of somebody that have the power or the pen or the authority to promote you or to advance you. Congratulations. You will understand that around about Easter, okay? Oh, my God. Somebody else, plant your offering right now. Plant that $133, plant that $33 seed, plant that $11, whatever the Lord has placed upon your heart. I want you to plant your offering right now. God, we are recognizing that the devil is ahead, and the saints of God, we too slow. If anybody ought to be having ideas, it ought to be the saints of God, because we're the ones that are in prayer. We're the ones that go into prayer service and we're singing and we're in the presence of God and we're crying. And don't you know God is that I'm giving you ideas? I'm giving you thoughts? Somebody, I can do hair, but ooh, so many people do hair. They don't get their money. They don't get, why are you talking yourself out of it? It starts with an idea. Get your, Lord, give me an idea. Ooh. Am I making sense? Lord, give me an idea. Somebody right now, well, I can babysit children, or I can do this, or house sit for people. It starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. Dear, look at what you know how to do. Some of you right now, I'm talking to three people right now. You need to pull out your resume. Look at all the stuff that you know how to do. It starts with an idea. All you got to do is package it up and say, you know what? Hey, I am Michael Mosley Enterprises. This is what I do. It starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. Are y'all hearing me? I remember a lady came to me. I moved into a brand new home and it didn't have any, shades. And so what she did, she said, oh, I can get that for you. And I realized what she was doing. And later on, well, what she was doing was she was finding out how much it would cost to get blinds. And then she would add on, a fee, because she knew the information. I don't blame her, but that was her idea and that was her business. That was right. Now, yes, I went and found out a way to get it done cheaper, but I learned from that. That was her idea. And God prospered her. He did. And the others caught on, that was her way of making money. And then God eventually got into doing other things like doing landscape. But I come to tell you, it starts with an idea. I like that Diane Benton. Lord, give me an idea. I hear music. Are you singing? Do you sing? Are you a singer? I'm not talking about in the shower, I know. And we all sing in church. But do you have an ambition? It could be no. But I just hear when I said your name, I heard music. I heard music, like singing. Somebody else, plant your offering. Anybody else that's asking for prayer right now. And I believe tonight, I want you to ask God, Lord, give me an idea. Now, some of your ideas are going to, they're not going to be approved by everybody. I told you all, when I started, I did a 1-900 prophetic line. Ooh, I was blackballed. People were just like, oh, that's just not of God. I was trying to prove that whatever the psychic can do, the prophet can do. But the church didn't see it that way, but God did. God did. And right now I'm praising God because I'm living off of the rewards of what I tried to do. Does that make sense? Some of you, because you tried, and some people were not ready. Some people were not ready, or they are not ready for what God has given you. Melinda, does that make sense? Yes, Renee, I'm glad you're back. But let me make that very clear. Some people, I'm not eating emotions. Hit me. Some people are not ready. Can somebody write that for me? Some people are not ready for what God is giving. Well, let's say it this way. Some people are not ready for God's idea. Some people are not ready for God's idea. Some people are not ready for God's idea. They're not ready. God may tell you to go to the club and stand outside and pass out tracts. Ooh, I saw you at the club. God may tell you to go to the club and dance and have a ginger ale. I saw you, Reverend so-and-so. You sure did. You did. And I encouraged and prophesied to 18 people while I was there. And one person decided they're going to go back home to and reconnect with their marriage. But you did. But see, we don't see the fruit. Ooh, can I get 10 hearts right there? I know somebody, that ain't God. That ain't God. But that's God giving you some. Everybody's not ready for God's idea. Renee, yes, I got your cash. And thank you, darling. I appreciate you so very much. Thank you. Now, Sister Renee, the Lord, I have a zipper here, and this is what he's doing. He's saying, open your heart. Open your heart. Open your heart. Open your heart. I feel the Lord saying, open your heart. Now, I hear a song by, I think it was Dionne Warwick. I'm in love again. This time I mean it. In love again. I hear that. Now, I don't know if this is a relationship, but I definitely know I hear that it's time for you to fall back in love with life. Life now is sweet and my joy is complete, for I'm saved. I'm saved. I am saved. Well, that means you are special. You are accepted. You are included. So I need you to know, live. I feel like you're getting on a motorcycle. All right, let's go. Let's go for a good ride. Vroom, vroom. You're about to really hit a major level of success. God is saying, enjoy it. Enjoy it. Fall in love with the thrill of life. I pray that makes sense. Fall in love with the thrill of life. Joy. I feel, and you know, I hear that word, but I feel a lot of joy. I don't know why. I know you're a gospel singer, but I just feel like dancing. Hey, what's that? What the Harlem Shuffle? Down, 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 whatever that is. But I hear that, and I feel like people are dancing to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left. Now kick, now duck it, walk it, or something, whatever it is. I know it. I just can't think of it. But I feel like God is saying it's time for your party. It's time for you to celebrate. It's time for you to move forward. Go with the idea. Stop waiting on any and everybody else. I need you to lead. Start the party. Start the ball rolling. There's a flood of opportunities and cash that is coming into you. That's what he said. A flood of opportunities and cash that is coming into you. Diane, no, I'm not, but it is my desire to sing and do praise dance. I would like prayer as well. Father, I lift up Diane. I hear music. He that is merry, let him sing. That's the scripture. But Diane, I'm praying that God will continue. He's telling me you need to sow. You need to sow a $33 seed. Education. This is for education. This is what he's telling me. Did somebody hurt their left hand? All of a sudden, I feel like my left hand is hurting like, I feel like, I don't know, did somebody hurt their left hand? I'm talking to you, Diane. Just let me know. But the Lord is moving for you. God, we lift up Diane right now. We speak prosperity. Are you ready for it? I don't know if you're married right now, but I hear the word marriage. So I'm either praying for your marriage or either I'm praying for marriage. But we're going to say, God bless Diane in the area of marriage, okay? In the area of marriage, all right? Oh, who else is planting your seed offering? Do it right now. Would you mind? Do it right now. Plant your offering, y'all. Anybody ready for that idea? Renee, keep selling. Keep selling. Sale. On Facebook, sale. Keep going. And I really want you to hear me. Keep going. All right? People going to say, well, ain't nobody going to really buy it. There may be only one dress that you sold, but keep going. Keep. your right hand. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, he puts it in my left hand, but it's your right hand was in a car accident. Or you were in a car accident, so you hurt your right hand. Okay, I feel that as my left, but okay, I'm going to go with you. God, I want you to heal that right hand. Education. He's telling me again, education. Okay? And you desire to be married. You desire to be married. All right. So, and that's a wonderful desire. Don't worry about it. It's a wonderful desire. For some reason, I feel like he's already in your life. That's what I do feel. And I know always, well, who is it? Oh, Lord, let me go to thinking. I don't know. And no, don't ask me for no name because I ain't giving you one. But I am going to ask you to plant that $33 seed, okay? If you haven't done so already, I want you to plant that offering, okay? Mm-hmm. I want you to plant that offering. I like that. I'm ready for that big idea. You know what? James, I love your statement, but I just want you to go back to idea. Because even that small idea, because sometimes when God gives us a what it may look like a big idea, like, oh, Lord, can I do that? Oh, Lord, I don't know. But he had some, many times he starts small and he'll let it grow. He'll let it grow. And that's what I hear for somebody else. It's like, God, give me I want to make big money. You can make big money just with that selling that chocolate cake that you can make. Just with doing, what is it called, janitorial, house cleaning services. You can make big money because you don't know somebody that you may clean their house and you know what, here, you want this? This is, and they don't realize how valuable it is. And then they may know. They just don't care. Here, I'm tired of this. My ex-wife gave this to me. Here, you want this? You take it. That thing is valued over $100,000. Here, I don't care. Remember that show on Sanford and Son? The man was giving away a Steinway. It was a show, an episode. And Steinway is the most expensive piano there is. This piano is valued at $80,000 to $100,000. I don't care. It's my ex-wife. We divorced. Here, just take it. Just get it out of here. I'm like, Lord, why couldn't that be me? Why couldn't it be me? Renee, again, I was getting ready to say something and I stopped myself. But I see you really selling products, outfits and clothes. Some things are going to be not necessarily for church purpose, but there's a market for it. You sell it. All right? I know. No. Just that's what I'm hearing. So, you know, honey, we sell choir robes. Okay. But I'm going to tell you what I hear. I'm telling you what I, how you doing, Angelina? God bless your heart. We don't know how the Lord may bless us. And I know that's fictional, but no, I believe that has happened. Oh, I know someone that made over $60,000 for the year cleaning. Don't the scripture say his ways are past finding out? God is just telling somebody, hey, it just starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. I know one young lady, she told me she want to sell swimsuits. Well, somebody going swimming? Mm-mm, honey, them things too, they ain't holy. Well, they ain't meant to go to church in. They meant to go, yeah. Am I making sense? Oh, you know, that one light will birth more lights. You're right. I like that. Just somebody right now, is there somebody just thanking the Lord for an idea? Thank the Lord for an idea. Thank God. God, I thank you for my idea. And you may go to sleep tonight and God may give you an idea. God, well, how am I going to get the patent? Or how am I going to get license? Or how am I? Just start with the idea. Some things, the Bible said, as they went, they were healed. Just go with the idea right now. Wake up and say, you know what? I'm going to do this. And you can start Googling information. You all know what? Thank God for the day that we are in. And we can Google almost any and everything. Google it. Somebody need your idea. I think I'm going to sell lingerie. Well, some woman needs your idea. There's a husband right now saying, please sell my wife something. Please, you know, there's an idea. Thank God Luther could sing, Luther Vandross. He didn't sing gospel, but his idea, I can sing a love song. That brother could. Luther worked, he didn't sing in the church, but he sure helped populate the church. You all got what I'm saying right there, right? It starts with an idea, ladies and gentlemen. The devil is ahead and the saints are too slow. Anybody else that's asking for prayer, I thank God for all of you. Thank you today. Did you go to the YouTube? Renee, did you go to YouTube? Prophetically speaking now. I really need you to do that for me, Renee. I ain't playing. I'm serious. I'm serious. I believe I'm five people away. I'm checking right now while I'm here. I believe I'm four people away. I'm four. I need four of you right now to go to the YouTube channel, Prophetically Speaking Now. I had a goal of reaching 100 subscribers by today, by March the 5th. I'm only four away. Now, if you have not subscribed, please do so right now. Call your friend. Tell them, hey, go over there to YouTube, Prophetically Speaking Now. Crystal, are you on Prophetically? Have you subscribed? Crystal, I need you to subscribe. Go to Prophetically Speaking Now, okay? I need you to subscribe. Sister Renee, I need you to subscribe. No, I really hear that song. I need you to survive, right? But I need you to subscribe. It's helping me to enlarge our social media platform. And I told God, God, I'm ready to go for it. I'm doing this. I can't let the devil be ahead and then I'll be slow. And then some people say, oh, you don't need to be going over there asking folks to subscribe. Well, you do what you want to do. Until I know better, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask. You have not because you ask not. You know, some people say, don't be asking. I'm going to ask. I'm going to ask. Crystal, please do it. In fact, click on over if you can and do it right now and come back. Okay, if you can click over there to YouTube real quickly and type in Prophetically Speaking Now, you go see my face. How you doing, Elizabeth? Blessings to you, my dear. Elizabeth, it starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. Ooh, thank you so much, y'all. I see somebody. I just don't know your name, but it starts with an idea. I want you to keep going, Elizabeth, okay? Keep going. I see a baby. Not you go have a baby. No, I'm not saying that. But it's like I see a baby in your arms. I see a baby in your arms. And this is not your child, no, but I do see like a baby and you're carrying. I don't know if that means something new is coming into your life. But I have to tell you, I just see a baby in your arms. It's like you're admiring this child. Now, a baby could also mean a new business, a new idea, okay? That's what it could mean. So I want you to realize this. That was you that just subscribed, Renee. Thank you. Thank you. God bless y'all. Give my love to your sister. You know, everyone on YouTube asks to subscribe. Thank you. Don't listen to them negative. Angelina. Blessings to you, Angelina. Saints of God, I thank God for you. I really, really do. I am very serious. I really thank God. I've got 100 subscribers. I just checked. Woo, hallelujah. I got it. Thank you all so very much. Oh, y'all, I'm about ready to cry. It's only 100. Hey, it's the idea. If I start with 100, I'll get you with the 100, Crystal. Lord, I thank you. I thank you so very much. God bless your heart. I really do. Saints of God, I pray. And somebody else right now, and hear me. I'm not being funny. I really am happy. Okay, I really am. I really am. What is your idea? What is your idea? Get started with it. It may seem minute, it may seem small, but get busy with it, okay? Get busy with your idea. All right. You may say, I like to make mustard greens. I like cooking cabbage. Okay, well, cook it for a living. Freeze it and sell it. Whatever you can do. That's a way to make money. But it starts with an idea. Woo! I feel that one, y'all. I bless God for you. I thank you so very much. I pray you will bless anybody else that is asking for prayer on tonight. Let me know. Anybody else that's asking for prayer, y'all, it just starts with an idea. It starts with an idea. And I pray you got that message. Again, I said the devil is ahead, but the saints are just slow. God has given us so many ideas, but we talk ourselves out of it. You know, we talk, some of you can dance really good. Well, who said you got to be a stripper? There are many people that are looking for dancers to dance behind them when they singing and praise dancing and all. You know, everything is not, I guess, demonic. But you have the control over your body and all. You could start an exercise class. I knew a young lady, she did an exercise class. I forgot. She named it after Beyonce, but it's like B Fit or Bay Fit, something like that. And they would exercise to Beyonce's music, and you know, work it out. And she would train them. It starts with an idea, and some ideas are only maybe for a season, but another idea will come. And now she's not doing that; she's doing something else now. But another idea will come. So. Don't stop your idea. Guess what? I had my appeal hearing on the phone. They had the higher person, my lead in the area manager, to go against me. We went an hour, and still hadn't finished everything. I was prepared, 11 pages of documents. Keep your idea. Keep your idea. God is with me. I'm not failing. God is with me. And I want you to be confident of that. God is with me. I told them also, since they are flagging my unemployment benefits, I want these hours worked for free. Okay. I'm praying for you. And I really am. I'm praying for you. And we're going to believe God, because we're praying for you. We're praying for you to succeed. And it will be so. It will be so. Saints of God, I gotta go. I pray you were blessed on today. I thank you so very much. Thank you for being my 100 subscribers. I appreciate you so much. Now, I'm telling you, before somebody wake up in the morning, or somebody, you go probably won't be able to sleep tonight. Watch, because the Lord is gonna give you an idea. And you're like, oh, I can do that. Watch, get ready. You looking for something to use your income tax money on? Somebody getting ready to start a major business, but it starts with a small idea. I love you dearly. Father, I pray. First of all, let me thank you for this opportunity to share with these my friends, and thank you that they helped me to reach my personal goal of that 100 subscribers for YouTube by this date. Thank you. I appreciate you so very much. Now, God, I ask that you would continue to flood our hearts with the ideas that we can do right now. What is it that we can do that will make us an extra 10,000, 50,000, 100,000? What can we do that will help us to achieve ownership of our homes and our cars? Give us that idea. Money is not the problem. We just need an idea. And if you give us that idea, we're going to follow through. It is so, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. Amen. God bless you, everybody. I love you dearly. Now, go and listen for your idea. God bless you, everybody.